when I had wrote ICY GRL, it was a really difficult point in my life. I was renting rooms off of Craigslist. I was like broke. The situation just wasn't icy at all.
Hi, I'm Lakin, and I'm here with Saweetie, and we're gonna get our nails done and talk about her new EP, High Maintenance. Where do you remember first getting into like a beauty routine and like with your skin and your nails? Like, when did that start for you?
Well, I used to have a pizza face and
with acne.
Yes, and I was so oily. My poor dad, he would tell me to wash my face with a hot towel. So I would do that, and then I went to go visit my mom, and she was like, "Girl, what's going on with your face?" So she gave me like introduced me to face wash. And I was like, wow, my face cleared up immediately. And then I discovered makeup in college, actually. Because I was only wearing like mascara during my junior and senior year in high school.
Right.
Like all these girls is baked up now. I'm like, dang, I did not look like that in high school.
Me neither.
Yeah. You know, like, I think it's cute that some of my fans are like, well, I can't be icy and I can't be high maintenance because I can't get my nails done. But it's just like, it's not necessarily getting your nails done. Like, just keep them clean, you know? It don't gotta be acrylics, it don't gotta be gel. Just keep them babies, like, you know, the dirt from underneath them.
Trying to get a bag of weed, I'm trying to get a bag of wheat. Put it in my savings and invest in the right companies. My dream is like a child and I'm taking all the custody.
So, like, I thought about this, especially with the high maintenance thing. And people might say, like, oh, if you have a beauty routine, then, like, you're superficial and you only care about your looks. But, like, do you get something from it that is, like, not about how good it looks on the outside, but, like, maybe that's how it makes you feel on the inside?
Well, you look good, you feel good. So I feel like everybody's beauty routine is different. And, you know, everybody has their preferences. So, I mean, I don't mind being called that if that's what taking care of myself is. I mean, call it what you want. I'm taking care of myself.
Yeah, that's so real. Wait, so high maintenance. Do you think it has, does it have like, is it like a double entendre?
It is, girl.
Why are you so tiny about it?
Well, yeah, I thought you knew. So, when I mean high maintenance, yeah, yes, my nails, yes, my hair, yes, my makeup is high maintenance. Like I said, like I was spending a lot of time with myself.
Right.
I'm with myself. So like my soul is high maintenance because I was reflecting, I was praying a lot, was talking to myself a lot. I was cooking a lot. I started to cook more for myself. Like stop eating out because you don't have the money to eat out.
Right.
So, you know, like cook good, you know, eat good, feel good. So like my body's high maintenance.
Where does that like strong like sense of self-awareness come from? Like,
you know, I was very like self-conscious, you know, insecure. I feel like as I progress with my career and, you know, just going to where I want to be at in life, I have slowly built like this confidence. So it's not something that has like happened overnight, but it's just like when you're like spending a lot of time with yourself and you're like reflecting, it's just like, okay, these are your weaknesses. This is what you're not happy about. And you know, I wanted to like change that because everything's all about mindset.
Right.
And that's what I see is it's a mindset. People think it's like, you know, like high maintenance. Like high maintenance is a mindset as well.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like about like the finer things in life, although it is sometimes. But it's like, you know, it's a mindset. Put a little, you know, illuminator so I can glow.
What exactly is illuminator?
Like the illuminator, the, oh, what is it? The, what's this?
Highlighter.
Highlighter.